In this tutorial, we will learn about drafting environment. We'll learn how to create 2D drawings from 3D models. At first, you will have to open your model for which you want to create drawing. Click on open, select your part, and click on open. Click on isometric view, then click on start, mechanical design, drafting. And from here you can choose the desired configuration. You can start with empty sheet, and then you will have to add the drawing views manually. You can create all the views in the same sheet, or you can choose three views, whether you want front, bottom, right, or front, top, left. I will choose this option, front, top, left. Then from here you can choose the sheet size. Click on modify. From here you can choose the standard for the sheet. I want it to be ISO. Then from here choose the sheet size. I want it to be A3. Then you can choose from here whether you want the sheet to be portrait or landscape. I will choose landscape. Click on OK. Click on OK. By pressing the first mouse button and dragging the mouse, you can position the views at desired position. Or you can select other view and drag it, and you can position it also. All the views are interlinked, so you cannot move it up and down. You can move it in horizontal direction only, because it is a side view. And if you move the main view, all the other views will move with that view. Then if you want to change the position of these annotations, you can press first mouse button and drag them and place them at desired positions. If you don't want to show the scale, you can double click on it and remove the scale from here. By selecting the content, you can give different font to it as per your standard. Then you can increase the size of it from here, font size. You can make it bold, italic, and other options you can control from here. Click on OK. And if you want to do the formatting to more than one text, select the text by pressing the control, and then you can format all the text at a time from here. Arial bold 5. Then to display the hidden lines and center line, select all the views by pressing control button. The selected views are shown with orange color. Then right click on any view and select properties. Then from here you will have to choose hidden, center line, axis, and thread. Then from here you can control the scale of the views. If you want to increase the size of the view, you will have to increase this first parameter, and if you want to reduce the scale, then you will have to increase this second parameter. That means if I give 1:2, the scale will be half, and if I give 2:1, scale will be double. From here you can change the orientation of the view by giving the angle. Click on OK. It is showing hidden lines and center lines. Then to display the dimensions which we have used to create this part, the toolbar is not visible. You can just remove this toolbar. Here is this toolbar. Here it is, generate dimensions. Click on it. So it will show all the dimensions that we used to create the views. Then click on OK. So it will show all the dimensions. You can press the first mouse button and drag the mouse to position the dimensions at proper positions. And if you want these diameter values to be horizontal, then select all the diameter values by pressing control button, right click on it, and select properties. Then click here on dimension line, and from your representation select these two part and click on OK. Click outside and you can drag them and place them at desired position. If you don't need some dimensions, now your 20 dimension is shown 3 times, you can select them and delete them. Select and press delete button on the keyboard. Now if you want to add isometric view for this part, then click here and select isometric view. Then click here on window. Choose your part. Our part is plate. Then select one face. From here you can change the position by clicking on these arrows as per your requirement. And click outside. Then you can drag it and place it at desired position. Now it is not fitting within the sheet. If you want to change the sheet size, then right click on the sheet one, click on properties, and from here you can change the sheet size. Suppose I want it to be A2. By changing the scale, it will change the scale of all the views on that sheet. And from here you can define projection method, whether it is as per first angle or third angle method of projection. And click on OK. Then you can drag the views and place them at desired position. Then if you want to add some notes to the drawing, then here is the text command. Click on it, give the position, and write down your notes. To bring your cursor below, press Ctrl and Enter. If you press Enter without holding the Ctrl button, then this OK will be pressed and your command will complete. Therefore, to bring this cursor below, you will have to press the Ctrl and then press the Enter. Again, press Ctrl and press Enter. Then if you want to change the font, select the text. And from here you can change its font. You can change its size from here. You can make it bold. Same way for below lines. Change the size. Then from here you can change the alignment, justification, whether you want it center, right or left. And from here you can add some symbols. Then click on OK. In this way you can add the notes. Then to add the sheet format, click on Edit and select Sheet Background. Then here new button is added, Frame and Title Block, click on it. Then from here you can choose the available sheet format and select Create and click on Apply. And OK, your sheet will be added properly. Then if you want to make changes to anything, just double click on it and you can make changes to the text. Click on OK. Then to go back to view mode, click on Edit and click on Working Views. We'll come back to your view modes. If you want to add one more sheet to this drawing, then here is the sheet button, new sheet. Click on it. It will add new sheet to the drawing. And by right clicking on this sheet 2 and properties, you can control its size. Suppose I want it to be A3. From here you can choose the projection method. I want it in first angle. Then from here you can choose the scale. Click on OK. Now here my sheet format is bigger and sheet size is smaller. To change the sheet format, click on Edit, click on Sheet Background, then click on Frame and Title Block and click on this Resize button and Apply and OK. So it will keep the changes we have made as it is and it will resize as per our new sheet size. Click on Edit, Working Views. Then if you want to create drawing for other part here, then open the other part, click on Open, then select the other part. Suppose I want to create drawing for this vertical plate, click on Open, then click on Isometric View, then click on Window and go back to your drawing one. Then to add the views manually, click here and select Front View, then click on Window, select our new part, that is this vertical plate, and select the front view. Suppose I want this side as a front view, click on it. And after your selection also you can change the sides from here if required. Click outside. just drag it and place it at desired position. And by clicking on it, you can add the projection views. Click on projection view, take the side and click there. You can click on projection view and click there. And to add the isometric view, click on the isometric view, click on window, click on vertical plate and select one face of the object and click outside. Drag it and place it. Then by selecting the views, you can make it hidden, add the center lines automatically, add the dimensions. And here if some dimensions are not shown, and if you want to add the dimensions manually, then here is the dimension toolbar. All the types of different dimensions you can add from here. Suppose I want to add the radius for this circle, click on this R, zoom it, click on this circle, take your cursor outside and click there. Or I want to add length for this line, click here and select dimension, click the inclined line, give the location. So in this way, if some dimensions are not shown automatically, you can add them manually. And if you want to add detailing of other part in the same sheet, then again you will have to follow the same procedure. You will have to open the part and take the front view and create the front view. In that way, in single sheet you can add detailing for multiple parts also. That's all. Thanks for watching. We will stop here.